Hey guys, I'm Robert. You know how some ideas hit you in the most inconvenient time? I've spent years looking ways to capture these thoughts instantly. Many videos on this channel actually started as quick voice memos I recorded while walking my dogs. After testing countless apps and workflows over the years, I've built several friction-free systems for emptying my brain. Today, I want to focus on one key part of this, which is digital scratchpads. These scratchpads replicate the experience of quickly writing thoughts on paper so you can focus on something else you have at hand. I have previously shared my Alfred and Bear capture workflow, which is great for sending text to an inbox note. I have also shared a shortcut that I use for sending tasks in a similar way to Craft. But there's something even more fascinating I have been studying, and this is about how thinking is not just about getting ideas out of our heads, it's a conversation between our minds and the tools that we use, similar to how artists develop their work through feedback between marks on a page. We see this a lot in handwriting as well, how the physicality of the process helps create stronger memory and connections. So, even though such a thing may not be totally possible to replicate digitally, there's actually a lot of value on using methods that allow you not only to quickly capture thoughts, but let these thoughts grow or develop at the same time, even if it's just something that happens really quickly. And because of this, I believe visual feedback of what you are capturing or what you have previously captured in many cases is important. This is where the concept of digital scratchpads fits right in for me. I use Yabai for Windows management. It keeps everything organized in an invisible grid. This app has a scratchpad feature that still blows my mind, especially since few people seem to know about it. I have it set so that when I press caps lock and space, I instantly get a floating bare note that appears on top of everything else. I can type or I can dictate any thoughts that I have in any given moment. And then I simply hide it with the same keyboard shortcut so that I can continue working on whatever else I was doing before. When I need it again, even if I'm on a totally different workspace, the same shortcut brings that same note back. And by the way, this window is on top of all the others on a separate level. This means that I can even interact with my windows below and my scratchpad will still be visible. As you saw, it's even separate from the main bare window that has my other notes. It already has a tag for organization. It has the date and the time as a title. So let's say that I want to promote this to an actual, more permanent note. I can rename it if I want. This is a new title. And then I can simply close this window. That's it. I can find it in my inbox anytime or move it somewhere else within my organization. If I press my scratchpad shortcut again, a new one is created. Oh, and if I double click any of my notes, it takes the place of my scratchpad and I can hide it or bring it up just like before. It's super simple, super convenient. With Yabai, it gets much more powerful because you can make any window from any app into a scratchpad. I use this with Spotify, for example, when I'm listening to music. I just bring my Spotify scratchpad up for switching tracks and I can toggle it off again. I also do that often with a browser window to quickly access information from a specific website. The capabilities of Yabai go far beyond this, but my intention here is not to dive deep into all its features. It can get quite technical and intimidating for some users, and I think there's already some other good videos that can guide you through the setup. I will still give you my configuration files in case you want to check that out, but what I have actually been looking for since I discovered this are simpler alternatives to these scratchpad notes that I can recommend to you guys. For a while now, I have known about Sidenotes, which allows you to take notes wherever you are by bringing up a panel on the side. I have only been testing this recently, but it is a solid app and many users actually swear by it. It supports Markdown, several formatting options. You can even store images or files. And one thing I have to tell you is that in the App Store, it only gives you the option to purchase. But if you go to their website, you can try the app for 30 days before buying. However, if you already have a good note-taking app, this might feel redundant. You could end up with scattered notes everywhere. If you plan to use this as a temporary storage, you can still drag out notes from here and bring them into another app like Bear. Another alternative that I was surprised to find is menu bar note-taking apps. There are tons of apps in this category, and I'll give you a link for you to check this out. Honestly, most of these work fine. To me, it just comes down to user experience. Consider how quick it is to toggle the app, save content, and get back to what you were doing. It's also a good idea to think about how easy it is to get notes out of here in case you do want them to become part of your more permanent note-taking app. The less friction, the better. Something that seems much more interesting to me is an app like Antinote. This one goes more with my preferred concept because it's super minimal and it provides a similar flexibility to what I have with my Yabai setup. I can hide it and I can bring it back across different workspaces with the same shortcut. It looks really nice. It supports some Markdown, and something that makes this even more convenient for this Scratchpad purpose is that with another keyboard shortcut, you can easily send all the content you have typed to your preferred app. In my case, it's Bear. Let me do that to show you. We have multiple export options for this in the settings, but if the app you use doesn't appear here, then you can also connect it with anything that integrates with shortcuts or with URL schemes. So there's a lot of interesting possibilities there. Now, these are the only features I'm looking for in an app like this, but Antinote can do a lot more. Something I have enjoyed playing with is this sort of built-in pay stack. If you activate it, everything you copy will be automatically added to your note. This, combined with an extension like Stop the Madness, it's very useful to gather URLs, for example. I am just pressing Command C when hovering over links, and everything goes to my note. Then, with just a couple of tabs, it all goes to Readwise Reader, which I use for Read It Later. Okay, now I can go and check on Reader. Let's go to my library, and there we go. The links that I have on my Scratchpad. Another thing is that if you take a screenshot and if you drag it or paste it, it will extract the text. It also supports inline conversions, calculations, checklists, timers. You can create multiple notes and swipe across them. It even has Alfred and Raycast integrations to add and search content. This app can do so much, in fact, that again, you may end up wanting to use this for long-term storage, and I'm not quite sure how it would perform for that purpose. So you definitely need to set a system for yourself and define how you plan to use it. I am very happy that all the features are not up in your face, so it doesn't feel overwhelming. And you can give it a very basic use if that's all you need. If I didn't have Yabai Scratchpads, I'll be using this 100%. I am still debating if I should just switch to this, but overall, it's a $5 app that I think is absolutely worth its price tag. If you don't need all the bells and whistles from Antinote and you're okay with something less polished, a few days ago I discovered an app called ScrapNote, and this one is completely free. This also has that feature that allows you to quickly hide or bring up your note across different workspaces. And you can also export the contents of your Scratchpad by using shortcuts. To be honest, after trying out Antinote, everything else feels a bit lacking, but I still wanted to give you this alternative because I'm thankful that the developer has put it up for free. And there you have it, guys. Any of these options I've shown you, or even the menu bar alternatives, should give you a solid starting point. I still keep some pen and paper on my desk at all times and may still record a quick voice memo now and then when I'm outside. As I was telling you, the real magic here isn't in finding the perfect app. It's in building that habit of staying alert to those little sparks that come your way throughout the day. Maybe it's a sudden burst of inspiration, an interesting piece of information, or even a random random thought that could turn into something bigger. Don't let those slip away. Give them space to breathe and grow. I hope this helps some of you build better capture systems. If you've got a setup or tool that has been big for you in this area, or if there's something specific you would like me to explore deeper, drop it in the comments. I love hearing about how you guys are doing things and answering your questions. And hey, if you want to stay more up to date with what I'm working on or what's caught my attention lately, remember you can sign up to the newsletter. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one.